Drop down, snap, and then after that, you just drop in, ride the bell, and get pitted.
We are the Shred Pill.
We are taking the Shred Pill today, my friends.
What do you want? Woo-woo!
the secret chiefs, huh?
Yes, they shred the gnar.
Ah.
And the guitar.
There's a kid. There's a kid at my pizza joint that talks like that.
Yeah? Does he shred the gnar, bro?
He took the Shred Pill.
Yeah?
Well, Gnar Taco is one of the best taco places I've been to in Telluride.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's like shrimp tempura, fucking tacos and badass shit.
Whoa, dude.
Cha, bro.
Secret Chiefs. Who's in the Secret Chiefs again?
That is the guitarist for Mr. Bungle.
That's why it sounds like
Mr. Bungle. But instrumental and surfy. You can tell...
I thought it was Patton related.
Yeah, you can tell he's that element of Mr. Bungle. Yep. Pretty much all instrumental. Good stuff. What's his name? Trey... I don't know how to pronounce that name. Let me see if Wikipedia tells me how.
It's not Trey Anastasio.
Trey Spruance is how it looks. I don't know how you're supposed to pronounce that.
Look at that fucking sexy European broad right there.
She kind of has a Cro-Magnon forehead, I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, well, I've been watching a lot of this dude. I think I saw it on Red Ice Radio. Was interviewing this guy from England who's all obsessed with ancient European peoples. And apparently, like, pretty much everybody from Europe has at least 3% fucking Neanderthal.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's...
I feel like a lot of Americans do, too, though.
Well, that's because they're Europeans.
Yeah, that's...
Yeah, because we're descended.
This is not a nation of immigrants.
No.
It's
a nation of Neanderthals, or at least it would be a lot cooler if it was, because, you know, the Neanderthals understood the Shred Pill. They were out there hunting mammoths and shredding gnar.
Neanderthals are so gnar, bro. They're so shredded.
Oh, they're just pitted, man.
They're fucking
They're in the tar pits, you know, the mammoths in the tar pits, just so pitted.
So pitted, bro.
Yes, this is a late night episode here, Podzeners. So this might get weird.
I'm going to explain why, because we got a telepathic sandwich show this weekend, and so to make that happen, my day job had to get all fuckered up with the schedule, so it's my fault. I take the blame.
Do we have a drummer yet? You don't know that yet?
Danger.
Said that dude hit him up from a new phone number. So he just has to re-find that phone number so he can get back to him and tell him when rehearsal is.
Cool.
All band stuff.
Yeah.
Whoa. Totally taking the shred pill there.
You got my text about Wednesday, Friday, right?
Show.
For sure. Show. Cool.
And I'm sure the Podziners really want to know our fucking...
I know. Oh, I just it was on my mind. I didn't want to forget.
Our rehearsal schedule.
I didn't want to forget. Sorry. Sorry, Podziners.
We don't have business meetings here at Obscene Podzine.
We just podcast all our business.
We barely communicate outside of this, to be honest. It's kind of funny.
Well, you like, want to
Yes, it's true. I do want to. Woo-woo-woo!
Oh, yeah?
I got the soundboard back.
Yes, this is an incredible thing. And I guess that sound means that I should find whatever we have for headlines, because that is
the headlines drop.
Supposedly what it's supposed to mean. So there's really not all that much. I haven't been keeping... I did barely anything for this episode, and I'm tired as hell, which is pretty sweet.
Yeah.
But I've seen a couple things around. So there's been... This is an old thing. But there's been all this Biden stuff going around lately. So people have been talking about the great Joe, who is there competing with our Lord and Savior, Bernie. Bernie Christ.
Yes.
Uncle Joe.
Yes, Uncle Joe.
Uncle Joe and Bernie Christ.
Yes, Bernie Christ. But yes, this is, I believe it was a while ago that this happened, but Joe Biden and Lady Gaga in October 2017, teamed up for a sexual assault public service announcement.
Oh, that was in 2017? I just saw that.
It looks like Lady Gaga is touching Joe Biden inappropriately. I think we should address that.
Yeah, and she looks just like Hillary Clinton with that haircut. I think that's intentional.
Oh my God, yeah.
I think she is setting herself up as a, I don't know, she's maybe got injected with some clone spores or something.
So
the virus is spreading.
Funny thing you say that, Jam Jam. Back in the day when I was managing Journey's store, I got a little bit... Well, I think I might actually got it when I was at Radio Shack, but like...
When you were managing Journey?
Yeah.
Why didn't you hook us up, buddy?
I had to get a little bit of... I had to get a little bit of like sensitivity training because I was, you know, important. Uh-huh. And part of that was like when you're consoling an employee, the appropriate places where you can have bodily contact. And there's only one place that is considered non-sexual, and it's the elbow. So she's touching his shoulder. That shit's sexual.
Up. Ass to ass. Lady Gaga, Joe Biden.
He's a fag.
He's a lot of things. Joe Biden is a lot of things, and not the least of which is
ain't it cool?
Is a great bomb dropping of human being.
That is true. He was part of the great bomb dropping of how long was Obama president?
15 years. I don't know. Yeah. George Bush too. George Bush 3, I mean. George W. Bush 2.
Oh, and Mr. Trump, he's George Bush freaking 4 now. Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah. Clinton the
3rd. This guy's ridiculous.
What's going on there? I don't even know.
I don't know. I haven't listened to the news in a while. I've been getting shred pilled, man. Fuck the red pill. Take the shred pill.
That's right.
Bro. Like just ride the waves, man. Just shred the gnar and shred your guitar.
Gnar.
And because, you know... Like, Joe Biden has a lot of fucking dirty laundry. We all have a lot of things that we want to shove to the back of our past and have nobody look at. So we need to get shred-pilled the other way now that it's tax season and bring out the paper shredders.
Whoa, are we listening to Tom Waits this episode? Hell yeah. It's a good song, too.
Yes.
It's a great song.
Oh yeah,
this is probably one of my favorites. Have we played this on the Podzine?
No, not this one. No,
that's surprising.
Yeah,
for a buck.
I first heard this song on the Smartest Men in the Room movie, which is about Enron.
Tom Waits is going to be in a new movie.
Dracula 2 about that.
No,
is Keanu Reeves back?
It's called The Dead Won't Die, and it's a zombie comedy. It looks like
he would.
Yeah, pretty much.
Killers, his best role was Dracula, bro.
Did you see him in Seven Psychopaths? He was fucking brilliant.
What's Seven Psychopaths?
It's a... like a hitman comedy movie.
You see
it's
him?
Pretty funny. No.
You see him in Mystery Men?
Yes, I did. Fucking, I've seen everything Tom Waits has ever been in, sir.
That was the first time I ever saw Tom Waits. I had no idea who he was.
I didn't know who he was back then. But the thing that turned me on to him was Fight Club.
Nah.
Because, what is the name of the song?
I don't know. I didn't know he was in there. I know that. Where Is My Mind is in Fight
Where
Club.
Is My Mind has got super popular because of that, too. But, yeah.
The percussion in this song, I don't know what it is.
It's so great.
It's, but it's perfect. I know on a lot of their stuff, they were like banging wood like, against things.
I like the trumpet.
Oh yeah.
God's business.
Yeah, his percussive stuff is the way to go when he's you know, when there's no percussion, he's trying to be like, what, have a ballad or something. It's terrible, usually.
Oh, yes. Yes, this song is one of my all times.
So, like, Going Out West, one of that's the name of the song. Too. To be good. Going Out West is the one that's in Fight Club. As of Swordfish Trombones, he just showed up to the studio and was like, hey, so we're not going to have a drummer anymore. Here's some trash cans and some sticks, and just make that work.
Guy's a freak.
I want him to go on tour again so bad, because I've never seen him live, and he's not going to be alive that much longer. He's got to go on at least one more tour.
I guarantee you this would be the guy eyeballing me from the end of the bar, just talking shit. Like,
yep.
We would not be good drinking buddies, I'm sure.
No. I can't see getting along all that well with Tom Waits, period. I could see enjoying playing a show with him. I wouldn't
Fuck
mind
yeah.
being in his band for a while.
Yeah.
But no.
Yeah, no, his politics are pretty backwards.
I've got the strangest feeling someone's going to kick his ass.
It's true. This is true. So you should play us a little transition music here. You know, tranny music.
Yeah.
You Zionist pig. You occupying fuck.
Yes, that's the one. all right, so let's move on to voicemails here. We have
we'll get to it in a second, but we never got to My Sharona last week.
Yes. And in fact,
and that
let's
really
just do that right now before we get into listening to the voicemails here.
So this goes out to Marty.
And this is some guitar shredding here. My Sharona took the shred pill.
I'm totally. Going, hot dog, look at that, boy, look at that thing.
The Knack took the shred pill. And you can tell. They're just like Chad AF, bro.
So much you can do with that octave right there.
Oh, yeah.
Do-do-da-do-do-da-da-do-da-da.
Yep. It's really a one-note riff.
It really is.
Two. And there's then, that slide. That.
I still like the that terrible band's version.
Oh, yeah. The White Sharia.
Yeah. Might have to play that.
We can't promote them. They're terrible.
We're not promoting them. We're bringing light to the fact that they exist and
that they're horrible
them,
people.
Really. Oh, yeah.
The guitar tones in this. Two guitars. The one guitar only comes in when needed. Just
yeah.
comes in all... And the tones are very clean, too.
Very clean.
With just enough edge.
Just that little hint of overdrive.
Yep. And the
Not even a proper distortion.
Ooh. I love how hard love this solo. His solo is too.
I love how everything is even in this mix. The guitars are a little low. I'd probably bump those slightly, but like not much.
Yeah, it's a very
fairly clear. It's a good mix.
Yeah, it's a real good mix, and everything's so separated, left and right. Yeah. Hard pan guitars.
Yeah.
You can tell there are two guitarists, and they aren't overdubbing anything.
Taim Sharona.
Taim. Taim. Yeah, this song, I think we... When we played this last time, I think we talked a little bit about this. I don't know, was that the Rapapalooza?
It might have been.
Because this is not quite a statutory song.
I was going to say this is a rapey song.
There was one line, I think, that we got into.
Well, I can't remember. I always get it up for the touch of the younger kind.
That's what it was.
Yep. And it's specifically referring to his 17-year-old girlfriend at the time, which isn't quite statutory. Well, it depends on where you live.
In most states, that's still legal.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. But
as it should be. Come on, that's a fucking adult female right there.
Yep. Yeah, this is the full version with the extended solo.
Yeah.
Have to play that version.
As you should.
Not the radio version.
Yeah, gay. The gay-dio version.
This is the shred-pilled version.
That's
exactly.
Right.
Exactly. This was one of the songs on Guitar Hero that made people think they could really shred. It's like, you realize there's a lot more to playing the guitar than that, right?
Yeah. I don't think a lot of people do. I don't think a lot of people realize much.
Yeah. They don't.
I watch this jazz player on YouTube. He's got a YouTube channel. Named Adam Neely. If you want to learn some interesting jazz music theory, go check him out, Adam Neely. But he does these Q&As, and he was talking about how you can theoretically learn a piece if you're practicing on your forearm, like you're practicing your left-hand fingering, as long as you're pretty familiar with your instrument. And so somebody sent in a question, was like, well, then can't you learn a guitar from Guitar Hero? And he's like, that is not the same. Those are two very different things.
Well, Guitar Hero is just Dance Dance Revolution.
It's
for
true.
For your fingers.
For your fingers.
I think it's my favorite part.
Always like this drum sound too.
Yeah, I really dig the snare. It's really poppy.
Yep. I listened to that song a lot when right before I got into Rush. So when I was around 15 or so.
Don't trust them new niggas over there.
Oh.
Leaving they nigga essence in the air. Them happy, nappy-head niggas with the fingers on the trigger. Don't trust them new niggas over there.
Gross.
That's how mafia works?
All right. I think that's the transition music for yes. Requests. Is it?
Yeah.
All right. Let's voicemail it up. Brah.
Hey, guys. Yeah, I'd like to request George Thorogood's One Bourbon, One Scotch, and One Beer. Awesome song. A little bit lengthy, but never mind that. But now, one thing I found interesting, maybe you guys can comment on this. I don't know how true this is. Apparently, he never used a pick when playing his song. Apparently, he just, like, plays the guitar with his fingers. Yeah,
I've heard
super
that.
Super interesting, I know, but I don't know. Anyway, yeah, have a good one, guys.
I believe it.
I'm I'm pretty sure he's kind of a it's like a, almost a slap technique with his fingertips.
Uh-huh.
I'm pretty sure that's what he did.
I picked the live version so we can actually see that.
Yeah.
Nice.
Oh,
two more. It's God 2 minutes
damn.
Longer.
I didn't realize it was 11 minutes long. Yeah, see?
Yep.
The other one's like 8 minutes, so.
The thing about George Thorogood is he just writes a riff and then fucking talks over it for half an hour.
Yep.
Yeah, it's kind of like Les Claypool, right?
Pretty much.
But Les Claypool's, he does at least a different riff for the chorus.
No.
Nah.
Not always.
No. My name is Mud.
Jerry's a race car driver. That's two different riffs.
I don't think they can party in good in Jersey as they do in Philly. What do you think?
You got a chorus. This guy's got a chorus. When he hits the chorus.
It does.
And I got to say, this is like, this is pretty white guy shit.
Oh, yeah.
Pretty white privilege ass music with the guy talking about
I
not being able to pay
guitar.
The rent and telling his landlady to fuck off and going to get beer and shit.
Yep.
It's pretty working man. It's pretty 99% vote burn.
Yeah. Total 99%, bro. Get pitted, man.
He's fucking
man.
Pitted, dude. Fucking dude's pitted.
Totally shred pilled, man.
The next spot it went. And out the door I went.
Oh, shit. Guy's fucking stellar.
He looks like Tony Robbins.
He kind of does.
I don't see that. But I like the
Is that an Ibanez that he's playing? Or is that a Gretsch? That's not a Gretsch.
I don't know what that is.
But I love it. It's a semi-hollow.
Yeah, semi-hollows, dude. Yeah. They scream, bro.
Yeah.
I said, no. I can't find no job. I'm going to get somebody to pay this rent.
I said, no.
She said, I don't even try to find no job. Said, all she needed today was standing on a corner. Leaning up against a post. I say, but I'm tired.
I like to hear the new age version of this about like Mexicans flooding the border, take his job and shit.
Now you know next spot coming, I couldn't get the rent.
Like Trump's so cool. What'd he say? I'm gonna give a year warning.
Yeah.
To Mexico. The guy's not even pretending anymore. He doesn't. What Tucker Carlson was right. The dude's trying to lose the election. He wants out, bro. This fucking guy's a faggot. Fuck this faggot.
He's not shred pilled.
He's just a faggot.
Now, Bernie Sanders, though, he's totally shred pilled, dude.
He like shreds the gnar for sure.
Like that dude's Sanders. Nonstop blazing the dank and shredding the gnar, bro.
That's
hips,
right.
Hips be damned.
You know how them fucking wacky Jews shred the gnar, bro.
Oh, yeah, up in Aspen. All day.
At his seventh house, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
You know, for the 99%. We're all invited.
Yeah, he has to have seven houses for the 99%.
Yeah, we're all invited. We can all go and stay at his house anytime we want.
Yeah, and y'all should do that. Just show up, be like, yo, man, National Socialism, bro.
It's a socialist society, right? What's yours is mine, baby.
Yeah, and it's democratic.
Exactly.
We vote to get let the fuck in.
Yeah.
Are you ready to boogie?
Are you ready to boogie?
Let's boogie, baby.
An old friend of mine, the world's baddest boogie guitar player, and a good friend of mine from Tulsa, Oklahoma.
I don't know about that.
I like how this dude is dressed. This guy is fucking stellar. Tread pill as fuck.
Oh, yeah.
That's a Gretsch.
Who's that dude?
I wonder if he drove a fucking semi to the gig. Shows
nah,
up with a fucking 18-wheeler.
It's a pickup truck from like 64.
Yeah.
Probably got a couple of bales of hay in the back.
I like the taped down selector.
Yeah.
Knob.
Yeah.
Feeling good. Feeling groovy. Drinking bourbon. Scotch. And beer. Miller High Life, champagne.
Sounds like my night out.
Safer when you're having more than one.
Miller High Life, the champagne of beer.
Hey, it ain't bad. I'll drink it.
This is 84, so this is long before, like, beer snobs had a thing to be snobby about.
This is long before, like, High Life was brewed in Africa.
I'll have an IPA, extra hops.
Yeah, for my man boobies.
It has to be so microbrew that there's only like two beers in the world from it.
Yeah. A soy IPA. You know? And then I can go and get pegged by my girlfriend.
One beer.
Mr. Bartender, fill up my glass. Give me a drink, you know I ain't have enough. Give me an Elvin and shot of that Jersey stuff. While I get drunk, don't you?
I want to know what his pickups are set to.
Which pickups? Thoroughgoods or the other dude?
The one who has the
tape down? Yeah. Probably in the downward position, which should be Bridge.
Well, he's also got that little fucking dial, selector dial there. I'm not sure what that does. Does different things on different guitars. But it sure looks like there is something there that's all taped down. You could have just taken it and switched over to a dial doohickey for some phase options. I don't know. Fishing club?
Yeah, dude. Yeah. Look at his face. Dude, the dude's
San Mateo
dude's cool.
Fishing club. Yeah, dude is shredding the guitar. Shredding the gnar. Shredding his tax returns.
Votes burn.
Votes burn. He was voting burn right there, right now. It was 84, and he was voting burn.
Yeah. I mean, Burn was still doing congressional shit back then, wasn't he?
I'm sure he was doing something. Maybe that
was
his
pretending to, at least.
Past
no,
his
commune
day.
He was in Cuba back then. That's what it was.
Ah. Smoking the cigarro.
Saxophone shredding the gnar, too.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
I bet that's an Ibanez, actually. The one that Thoroughgood's playing.
Doesn't look like an Ibanez.
No, maybe not. I'm full of shit. That headstock is not an Ibanez headstock.
It's hard to tell what that is, but
maybe it's a Gibson. I don't fucking know, but I love it. It sounds killer.
Then we sit there.
It's a Gibson. That's a Gibson.
Yeah. Gibson.
Baby.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There we go.
Gibson.
Don't know what model.
Semi-hollow. That's the big part that matters.
Yep.
They don't make a whole bunch of different semi-hollows. I'm sure there's only like three bodies or something that they do.
Especially that single cut semi-hollow.
Right.
Listen to the BB King on a jukebox. Listen to the Muddy Hoochie Coochie Van Waters. Listen to Lightning Hopkins.
That snare sound. So
it's got a slapback on it.
Yep.
Or it's picking up the slapback from the arena.
Yeah.
Look how low that stage is too.
Yeah.
That's fucking crazy. That looks fun.
Yeah.
Because it looks like a big joint, but it's the stage is like ankle
Capitol
height.
Theater, wherever that is. Capitol aware.
Yeah.
Capitol Theater, I feel like,
New Jersey.
Yeah, I was going to say New York somewhere, but Jersey. It's close enough.
It don't.
We're sitting there with Elvin and the boys. Drinking bourbon.
Yeah, the sax and bass player look like they're right out of the gym.
Yeah. They're just chopping down trees before the show.
Yeah.
Shredding the gnar, man.
Yeah, shredding the gnar in the fucking Northwoods. Northwestwoods. Lumberjacking and shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a total... This is... George Thurgood's 99% is fuck, bro.
Yeah.
Totally pitted.
Yep. Did nothing wrong.
Ooh, I love those low notes.
Not a thin.
Woo! I looked down a bar and said, Mr. Bartender, come on down here. I know the bar.
Come on down here.
That's true. I've been to bars in Jersey. Went to my first strip club in Jersey when I was 18.
Oh, yeah?
BYOB. It was pretty cool. Sexy ass bitches.
Last call for alcohol. Is it what you want? One bourbon, one scotch, one beer. See my baby since almost a week. Need a drink so bad, man, I can't even speak. Wanna get high, man, listen to me. One drink ain't enough, man, you better bring three. While I get drunk, I wanna make it real clear. I want one bourbon, one scotch.
Nice.
One beer.
An acceptable audience participation moment.
And right at the very end of the song on the most predictable line of it. Yeah.
And not every chorus like some corn ass, Jonathan Davis ass, lazy faggot ass.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. All right. Next voicemail.
Ruins his whole fucking shows doing that shit.
Pause the scene. I want you to play I want you to play Serving Time in the Middle of Nowhere by I Hate God. Enjoy.
Ooh.
Whoa.
He hates
edgy.
God. That's pretty mean, bro.
Those guys used to tour with Pantera back in the day.
It's like super edgy, man.
Cha, bro.
Southern Discomfort. Yeah, that sounds like they would tour with Pantera.
I haven't listened to I Hate God in fucking forever.
Ooh. Oh, that's a good fucking groove.
Yeah, it is. I just wish it was EQ'd a little bit better.
Yeah, I wish the snare had just a little more pop to it.
The guitar, too. The guitar needs just a little bit more highs.
Yep.
Very nice, though. I like the vocal production.
Yeah.
It's totes like... industrial, bro.
This is the time when doing shit like this, they were running through like a guitar distortion pedal. Their vocals were going through guitar distortion.
Ooh, I like those toms though.
Yeah.
Drummer's solid.
Yeah.
That kick is nice and ballsy too.
Yep. Yeah, it's mostly that snare. And it's fine. I could just use a little more.
Yeah. My biggest issue, though, is those guitars. I just feel like there needs to be more on the top of it.
Nah.
I like them, kind of.
They're grimy, sure, but you can get more presence out of them.
Yeah, then they'd be Metallica.
No, not that much more presence. We're not scooping that shit. No.
Yeah. Somewhere between Queens of the Stone Age and Metallica.
Yeah, there you go.
No high end or too
Queens.
Much.
Queens would just be just as high mid notch.
Yeah. Well, and that's Lamb of God's the same way. Mark Morton is all about the mid tones.
Yeah. Yeah, like on fucking Songs for the Deaf. Like, I don't think there's a song with a tone knob that's not rolled down
right.
for the rhythm guitar track.
Yep.
Very solid groove.
Yeah, the pockets right there.
Oh, yeah.
And they drag it all together, too. When the drummer drags, the bass player slows down, you can feel it.
Oh, yeah. It's very stoner rocky, like tight stoner rock.
And I like how he's... The drummer's kind of got an overall slow beat, but then makes it busy in times within the beat. Like, it's a slow beat, but then adds a... You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, right there. Like, bro, make up your mind. Are you fucking Electric Wizard or you're Mitch Mitchell? What are you doing? Yeah, good request.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I haven't listened to I Hate God in a long time. Thank you for that.
I dig that shit. Yeah, they list Melvins as an influence, which makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
amongst other people.
We got any more headlines? It's something else we can talk about, right?
There's a couple more headlines, isn't there?
Talk about not really. There's not all that much in the way of headlines, but
I thought I saw a whole list of headlines.
There's old shit, but I don't know if there's all that much I really care about right now. For now that we're getting all shred pilled.
What is Alien Comics bad opinions?
That's just about some comic strip guy who has the wrong opinions. Might as well bring it up then, since you
since I said it.
I just saw this on Facebook. I've been seeing this guy's stuff shared around, and it's been entertaining enough. But there's a
it's a nylon thing. You know it's legit.
Yeah. So the dude who does these alien comics, Nylon says that he has really bad opinions on abortion.
That's funny. Bad opinions, huh?
Yes.
His opinions are just flat out bad on abortion. What he's against? And let me guess. Is he against the murdering of unborn humans?
Or born humans, because that's what it's...
Because that is considered abortion now, too?
Yeah. Yeah. Cartoonist Nathan Pyle, whose strange planet alien drawings you've definitely seen everywhere, was discovered to be anti-abortion today, which serves as a valuable reminder that you should know about the person whose content you're sharing so that you can make sure they make no money if they have the wrong opinions.
Yeah, because their personal life affects their art.
Yes, well, it does, but
it's just funny. It's just I don't understand this demonizing of people who like don't want to kill babies.
Have you seen
how they take the moral high ground on this and continue to. To pretend to hold the moral high ground is
well, there's a new movie.
My mind.
Well, that's because the moral high ground isn't actually a real thing, and
this is true.
And they want you to think it is, so that they can pretend they have it and you don't.
There's a new movie that is in theaters right now, I believe. I can't remember.
That got blocked by Facebook on the first fucking day accidentally. Oops. So Mark Zuckerberg. Oops.
The star, it's an anti-abortion movie. It's about one of the ladies who used to be like the president of Planned Parenthood, and then she later in life, she's dead now, and later in life she became anti-Planned Parenthood.
Yep. I've heard about the person.
Or base Margaret Sanger. I used to hate Margaret Sanger, and now I'm like, based, bro, based.
The lady who's great starring in the movie.
Actually, she's not. I've looked into it. She's totally not.
Really?
Her husband is.
Oh. Yeah. Well.
I can't remember the name of the movie or the
everybody
name of the star.
Everybody knows the name.
Anyway,
of the movie.
She wrote this letter to Hollywood, the star of this movie, talking about how because Georgia just passed this law, and Hollywood is filming a lot of shit in Georgia these days. Georgia just passed a law that said if there's a fetal heartbeat detected, that abortion is then illegal. So if the doctor detects a heartbeat, then you can't abort the baby. So a lot of like Hollywood types, Alyssa Milano was the big one, have come out and said you should boycott Georgia.
Turning into some kind of feminist?
you shouldn't go, if your project is going to be filming in Georgia, then you should boycott that project, blah, 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 because of this law. And the star of this movie is from Georgia, and she is all about this law. She thinks the law is a good thing, and blah, blah, blah. So it's like been this big ordeal, and everyone, like, all of the names you would think are coming out and saying how horrible it is that they're killing, they're not killing babies in Georgia.
Yeah.
Not killing enough babies in Georgia.
Yeah, right.
According to Hollywood, right? And who lives in Georgia? 99%ers.
Yes.
Exactly.
Nothing. Atlanta full of 99%ers.
Yeah, if you ever sat in traffic in Atlanta, you know that.
Yeah, if you've ever been to a chicken joint in Atlanta, you will see so many 99%ers. So many.
I used to live in North Georgia, baby.
Really? But
yeah, I did.
I like Georgia.
Right outside Gainesville, Georgia. But lived on Lake Lanier, right next to Lake Lanier, anyway.
Not as cool as Arkansas.
So they hate this guy because the first line in his Instagram bio is that he follows Jesus and he doesn't like abortion, and so you should shun him from your life. It doesn't matter what else he does that you like. You legitimately should care about the points of view of the people who are making your propaganda, which is why we blatantly tell you that we worship Bernie Sanders here, that we support the 99%, that we are, we have taken quite a bit of money from Israel, and we could take your money too if you want to help support what we are doing here. And make it so that we can talk about people other than Bernie Sanders.
There are other people?
I don't know if other people even exist, but I don't know. Maybe you guys should get behind the paywall. obscene.rocks/donate. obscene.rocks/donate. And you can get behind our paywall and access all the classic episodes of Obscene Podzine and premium content that we've been kind of slack on getting any out to you recently. Things have been things are hectic here, but as soon as there are more of you, it'll be a lot easier for us to make more premium content.
This is true.
Yeah. The quantity of, what's it called? Economy of scale. I read that in Thomas Sowell book.
Basic economics, baby.
Yes. 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 But anyway.
That's how mafia works?
Yes. That is how mafia works.
The name of the movie is Unplanned, and the name of the lady it's telling a story of is Abby Johnson. She was a clinic director who left the organization to become a pro-life activist.
Get a life, Jews.
is that what she said?
Yeah. Yeah.
So we have another voicemail.
I think Jews would like that.
All right, let's listen.
All right.
Hello, scum dogs. This is the ghost of Brocky calling in. I don't know if you guys ever heard of John 5. He played for Manson for a while. He's got his own thing
going
on. Of
course we
have. He's got a new single called Midnight Mass. Why don't you go ahead and play that one for me? Also, maybe you bring back the bomb! Look at you guys.
this fucking guy, huh? Hey.
This fucking guy.
Hey.
This fucking guy over here.
Hey, Tony.
Of course we know who John 5 is. John 5 is a great guitar player.
Never heard of her.
Scared. Looks like why Tyler T.
Why would you do that with the ratio and the screen?
There are a lot of music videos these days that are doing that extremely widescreen thing.
Well, that's anamorphic. That I'm fine with, but like the super fisheye and the anamorphic was just a little too much for my eyes.
It's not enough for Arnold.
John 5 puts out a record a year, approximately.
Huh.
Just like
Buckethead. Zappa. Yeah.
Yep.
Ooh. Ooh.
Listen to this dude shred. Shred the gnar.
He is shredding the gnar like a motherfucker.
That's shred pill.
Oh, that's total shred pill right there.
That custom Telecaster.
Right?
Always liked the headstock on that thing. Can't. It's not that one, but he's not even playing the one with his special headstock.
Little sweepy sweepy.
Must be just using normal tellies now. Or at least normal shaped tellies.
Right.
This with Buckers. Oh yeah, good tones. I can't really hear any bass.
It's definitely way behind everything. Not it's important. Even behind the drums. In John Five's personal band, you're not there to see the bass player. You're there to watch Five shred up the stage.
Yep.
Ding-ba-ding-ding-ba-down.
Oh yeah, he's getting
that's
pitted.
Where the bass is.
Ooh,
nice.
Yeah, I love that.
Ooh. Oh, now that's shred pill.
That's super sweet right there.
That's totes. Just barrels, man.
Whoop-a! Whoop-a!
Whoop-a!
Very appropriate request for
yes.
today's topic.
Absolutely. Ooh.
Ghost of Dave Brocky, are you in our Telegram group? Because if you're not, you should get in
I
there.
Keep meaning to get in that shit.
You need just, to,
it's
yeah.
entertaining. It's nonstop
it's,
fun.
It's, yeah, dude, it's constant
yeah,
content.
We've got some transgender types in there now. It's pretty cool.
Yep.
Yeah. Furries.
Oh my!
Yeah, we are. Obscene Podzine is furry friendly.
Furries, trannies, and bears. Oh my!
Yes. We're fairly inclusive.
Yes.
They all burn.
Yeah.
I love that. Just fucking hit that lick over and over and over and over. Defecating on the premises.
come on. Nope.
Feisty cadavers.
All right, bring back the bomb.
Bring back yes. the bomb.
I love this song.
Yeah,
we don't have any Telegram requests, do we?
Yes, we do. We have one.
Oh, yeah, we do have one.
Ooh, I like this mix better than some of the other Guar mixes.
Yeah. This is one of the later records, that's why.
And the drums are just cranked.
Yeah.
Obscenely loud. Which means it's automatically a good mix.
And pummeling.
Yeah, that ride cymbal.
Yep.
Yeah.
Break back the bomb! This is one of those songs that just randomly jumps into my head.
I don't think I've ever heard this song.
Oh, yeah? This is like the third Guar song I ever heard. The first two had brass instruments on them, so I kind of thought they were like this weird extreme ska band. And then I heard this, and I was like, oh, this is what they do.
Yeah, great drum sound.
Yep.
Kind of swallowing that bass again, but...
Yep. Yeah, I'll bring those drums down a bit in the mix. They punch yeah. through
Whoa.
Enough. You don't need them that loud.
Whoa. I never heard Arnold say that before. Ooh.
Yep.
Ooh. Fuck yeah.
Dissonance.
Woohoo! Oh, that pocket.
Ooh, yeah. Listen to the groove with the dissonance on it. Yeah.
Yeah, right after the hit, saw boom with that ride. Fucking smooth, dude. Pitted, bro.
Oh, that's goddamn good.
This is definitely one that makes you want to get pitted, isn't
good
it?
Good use of siren.
Oh, yeah. Mosh
so
pitted,
many bands
bro.
Fucked that up.
bomb, I'll drop it on you.
These overhead mics are close, too.
Yeah.
I like close overhead mics. Not to destroy. Close overheads, distant rooms.
Just gaff some 57s to the fucking to the ride and the crash and boom. Well,
on the big productions, you do get the individual cymbals mic'd as well as having overheads. Like when they record fucking Neil Peart.
Seriously, he has a mic per cymbal? I figured they group his shit.
Not necessarily per cymbal, like not necessarily for every crash, but like for the hi hat and the ride.
Yeah. Okay, I got you.
You know, a specific ride mic.
Right.
Then overheads to get the crashes and all that, but for all that precision ride cymbal stuff. And that may even be the case on this track here, I don't know. That ride is very clear. But
I bet the mic is just closest to the ride.
Yeah, it could be right up on it.
It's probably setting right up over the top of it, like 8 inches, so that it's right next to the ride and then pointing at everything else.
Hopefully it's got the standard 3-to-5 ratio.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's fucking tight, too.
I don't know how these guys play this well with those huge costumes on. That's what always blew my mind.
Oh yeah, speaking of drummers, finally I published that article of our drummer
Skippy.
Yeah, on Tim Alexander. Ooh. So we're gonna have to play a Primus song here before the end. After our Telegram request.
I still gotta finish the TV article. The streaming cost.
The what?
Remember I was telling you about that? About what it costs to watch television now? For streaming stuff? If you want to watch all the good shows on the streaming apps?
I don't think you were.
2 weeks ago. I was. Because I was like, I'm going to finish it up, and then I'm going to post it on Nerdy. And you're like, sweet. And then I can post it up on Obscene, too.
I may have been high and thinking about something else when you said
entirely
that.
Entirely possible.
He was high and thinking about Bernie Sanders and Trent.
Yes. Goddamn degenerate.
Yes. And...
That's how mafia works.
Yes, indeed. So we have Telegram requests here. And if you want in our Telegram group, go to t.me/obscene and get on in there.
Shut up, you shifty Jew. I'll fucking kill you.
And we have a lot of, we have a friendly robot there. The obscene request line who will take your requests if you send them in. And we have one here, only one today. Thank you, my friend. This guy has an accent, so we wrote out his exact message right above the audio message, just in case we couldn't understand. So thank you for that. But your accent is badass, so I'm gonna play your message here.
Ciao.
Oh, Obzin Pazin. I request song "Public School is Communism" by The Decency. Well. Public school sucks. I was forced down to the level of cattle and was severely oppressed by the females, who are overrepresented in public schools, where they forced us to submit with the support of few adult beta males. We need to genocide teachers now and welcome our new overlords, robots. Robots can teach us, and robots are cool, brutal, and autistic.
Yes.
Fuck yes. The teachers,
yes,
bro.
Robot teachers.
Fuck teachers, dude. Robots
are cool, brutal, yeah. And
friendly
autistic.
Robot teachers.
Yes, yes, the
and that fucking Yang guy, he
change off his tongue.
The fucking Yang exactly. Guy keeps warning about the robots. The robots we should be learning from.
We are working with the robots here. We believe in robot inclusivity. We are not bigoted against robots like this Yang. But
we're like James Vanderbeek in that Power Rangers short film, and any nerdy folk will know what I'm talking about.
Oh, hello, Chris. Hello.
Yes. But yeah, they do. School does suck, and it is run by feminists and beta males, and we feel
this
your pain here. And so here is "Public School is Communism."
Maybe.
Are you playing?
Yeah. Is this going to...
Oh, there we go.
It was roadblock after roadblock, one command after another, that I must do just to prove I could survive. It was crazy to think that I could embrace power. I was young, how was I to know the score? But it's not like that anymore. Hold that torch, I see the faith in your eyes.
Some synthy synth.
And create what I desired. The walls of sound.
It's Marshall ding, ding, ding. Drum beat.
And their emitted demands. Circling down.
Ooh, I like that fill.
Public school is communism.
Sounds all fash wave.
Not, but with real drums.
Yeah.
Or at least trying to be real drums.
They at least have a.
It's like fast variation with on Peter
just
Gabriel or some
Pink Floyd, Europop. Yeah, 80s music.
Ding,
I like that.
Ding, 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 ding,
ding, ding, ding, ding.
Ooh.
Now that is
boom.
A floor tom.
Boom.
But it's not like that anymore. Hold that torch, I see the faith in your eyes. With grace that are marked against objective lines. With teachers that push you further out into the storm of relativism and scorn, a victim of the norm. They say dance with the clowns. Dance with me.
You say a victim of the Nord?
Be a lot cooler if he did.
Choice, the decision is made. Told that you're achieving. Alright, you are for deceiving.
Guy sounds like a British version of the dude from
to the headmaster's office.
Decemberists.
I knew you were gonna. I was trying to think of the name too. Yeah.
I don't know who the Decemberists are. I don't think.
Oh no.
But he sounds less like a cuck.
Yeah.
You don't know the Decemberists?
We might have to play that. Can we play that song?
We'll have to play them sometime. I don't know if today's the day.
Down to the headmaster's office we went. Down to the headmaster's office we
ding,
went.
Ding, ding, ding.
Public school is communism. You've got no choice. The decision is made.
See, you just need me playing guitar. I'd be like,
what's that?
Just throw little riffs in there, you know.
Yep.
You know.
Yeah, it would help a lot.
Yeah, it's like some shred build guitar in that bitch.
Yeah, it needs to get shredded, man. Take the shred pill, man. Just do it.
Yeah, imagine this all GarageBand style, you know, with the hits. Basically Orifice A doing it is what I'm saying.
Imagine it all GarageBand and less GarageBand.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Fuck yeah, dude. Smooth request, bruh.
Yeah, and real quick here, I want to just hear this again. Hear you say obzine podzine again here. Come on, play it.
Hello, obzine podzine.
Yes.
That needs to be a new drop.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Thank you. And... Oh, shit. All right, so because of this Tim Alexander article that is up on obscene.rocks right now, we're going to finish off here with a quick bit of Primus from their new album. Our very first episode of Obscene Podzine.
We played a song off of this.
But I think this one's a better song, frankly. And
so it would only be fitting for us to play it on this episode, our very last.
Yes, yes. Do not tune in next week. It's over. Seriously,
the franchise
folks.
Is over.
You know, keep funding us, and that won't actually be real one day. It can go on forever.
Forever. Forever.
It's all about this guitar part.
Who's the guitar on this record?
Oh, it's Larry always Lund. Larry. Larry Lund.
Larry's always been there.
But this...
He will never die.
This album has Tim Alexander back on the drums.
On the drums.
Which is why it's the best thing they've done since the last thing they did with Tim. But they actually wrote decently structured songs, which is what pissed me off about Green Naugahyde.
Yeah.
Is that there wasn't enough there in terms of songwriting. He was lazy with his bass tone, but it wasn't just that. He was lazy with songwriting. The best songwriting on that was
this
from,
almost sounds like he's playing the Wemolo.
It could be. The restraint of that guitar part.
Right.
And a total pocket. Just jerky. And the tone.
Yes.
Drums busy as hell.
Ooh, delay.
No, I think that's his sixth string fretless.
Yeah, I can hear it now. It was just he was doing so much on the low B that it sounded like the Wemolo.
And it's definitely fretless, and that's a lot of what that is.
Uh-huh.
Kicks.
There's Larry. Killer tone.
I love that he describes his guitar sound as chickens fighting robots.
Sounds about right.
Yeah.
This song just has good structure, too. Simple.
Yeah.
But doesn't just repeat a riff endlessly. But yeah, it's a good album that... Yes, Podziners. We have reached that time.
We have.
When we must move on.
Shekel time.
Move on to the new and exciting opportunities that await us outside of Obscene Podzine.
Yes. You've heard raining blood, but have you heard raining shekels?
Oh, yes. Yes, and we need your shekels so that we can continue to make this Podzine great again. Keep Podzine great, in fact.
Shred-pilled again.
Keep Podzine shred-pilled. And with your money, we can stay shred-pilled. We can get
be
totally pitted, bro.
Pitted for eternity.
So pitted. and we can just shred the holy, sacred gnar. Thou shalt not wipe out.
Whoa.
Blessed be obscene.